In this video, we will demonstrate how to assemble and install an ESB2 onto a Dixon load arm. Retap the base swivel mounting holes to clear out any paint. Apply a medium thread locker to the three mounting studs. Thread the three studs into the base swivel mounting holes until there are approximately two threads past the underside of the plate. If needed, use two nuts to help turn the stud. Tighten the bolts on the main body using a half-inch hex. Remove the spring preloaded cup from the main body. Slide the main body assembly onto the base swivel mounting studs. Use a lock washer and hex nut to fasten the bolts. Make sure the main body is level with the base swivel. It may be beneficial to take the travel stop end off at this stage. Replace the travel stop bolts to keep the ball bearings retained. Remove the center swivel assembly from the actuator body assembly. Bolt the center swivel assembly to the main static body using stainless steel bolts and spring washers. Make sure the male raceway body is against the main body. Align the center swivel so the travel stop bolts are four holes from the top. Set leg A of the loading arm into a horizontal position. Attach the loading arm clamp to the base swivel, ensuring the clamp tabs are vertical. The clamp should be located between the back of the flange and the weld. Attach the main handle to the clamp using the correct fasteners. Insert the torsion spring into the counterbalance. Slide the actuator body assembly onto the spring on the other side of the center swivel. Align the front hole of the actuator body with the main handle. Attach the main handle using the correct fasteners. Bolt the actuator body assembly to the center swivel using the stainless steel bolts and spring washers. If you have any issues aligning the holes, Swiveling the center swivel slightly may help. If the adjustment bolt is in, take it out. Lift leg A until it reaches above the normal rest position of the loading arm. The higher the load, the higher above the resting position you should start. Take off the brand cap. Install the adjustment bolt into the adjustment cylindrical nut at the minimum position. You may have to spin the spring to get the adjustment cylindrical nut to align. With right-handed springs, tighten the adjustment bolt should spin the torsion tune accessory clockwise. With the left-handed springs, it should spin counterclockwise. Insert the spring preloaded cup into the main static body to align with the spring's hook. Turn the spring preloaded cup clockwise for right hand or counterclockwise for left hand until you can't turn it anymore. Match the holes on the spring preloaded cup to the nearest set on the main static body and attach with the appropriate fasteners. Tighten the adjustment bolt until the arm supports itself and is in the correct position for your application. Reinstall the travel stop accessory. Adjust the travel stop accessory and the travel stop end to stop the loading arm in the desired orientation. Please note, the ball bearings are retained by the travel stop bolts that attach the travel stop end. Use caution when adjusting the travel stop end to avoid losing any ball bearings. Reinstall the brand cap, ensuring that the yellow dot on the adjustment cylindrical nut is within the min and max window. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please contact us at DixonValve.com. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.